My name is Colin Murphy. I'm a Senior Product Marketing Manager here at Microsoft, and I'm joined today with Anna Thomas, Data and Applied Scientist in the Data Division at Microsoft. And today we're going to talk about CLR in SQL Server, Azure SQL Database, which is the Common Language Runtime. So Anna, just can you explain a little bit why it's used in SQL Server?
Yeah, sure. So it's basically used to author stored procedures, custom triggers. It can even do things like user-defined types, functions, and aggregates. And because that the managed code compiles natively, it can actually result in significant performance increases in some scenarios.
Oh, cool. Can you show us an example of a couple of stored procedures?
So today I want to show you how to get started with CLR in Azure SQL Database Managed Instance and how it's the same as SQL Server. So the first thing we're going to want to do is actually enable this in our instance. By default, it's not enabled. And so in order to do that, we'll have to show the advanced options and then simply enable CLR. And once we've enabled CLR, we can then do something like initialize a schema called regex in this scenario. Whoops. And once we have a schema initialized, we can then create an assembly. An assembly is basically a reference to that compiled program that we have. And so this is that compiled binary. Now, we can't upload the file, but we can use the binary instead. So that's what we're doing here. And once we have that, we can then start to match some of the functionality that we had in our .NET program into our program here in SQL. So what you can see that I'm doing is I'm creating three functions using SP execute SQL and defining the functions regex max, and I'm just specifying the types there. And then I'm matching them to the external name of the assembly SQL CLR regex, and then the exact function within that that I want to be able to use in SQL. Similarly, I'm doing it for substring to create a substring, and you'll see what these look like in a few minutes, and as well as replace. So we'll do it for replace. And once we have these functions created, we can then test them out. And this is where kind of the cool bit comes into play. So what you'll see here is I have a few sample texts. And if you're from the US or you're familiar with Social Security numbers, you might notice that these are in a similar format as those. And with PII and GDPR, we know this is very important to many folks. But what I've done here is put the regular expression pattern for a social security number. And if you're not familiar with those, it's basically I'm saying, okay, they're going to have a number and there has to be three of them. Then we might have a dash. Then we'll have two more numbers, maybe a dash, and then four more numbers. And that would be a social security number.
Gotcha.
And so then we're just going to see, I can actually run this and we can see what each of these functions does. So what you can see is it's just put each option into an unnamed column. But here, the first one is taking in this here it is, and then what presumably might be a social security number is saying, is it a match? And we're getting a true because it's a match. And the second one is not a match, so we're getting a zero there. So the other function we did is a substring, so where we could actually find social security numbers within, maybe want to pull them out and further process them or do something with them. And then the last one is replace, so we can actually replace or mask those social security numbers with X's. So this is just one example of something cool that might be interesting and easier to do in a language like .NET than in T-SQL.
Okay, but then you're just executing T-SQL here, correct?
Just executing T-SQL here, we have native functions available for us to use. So it really makes it so that anyone, you know, other users can also leverage these functions that we've created.
Oh, that's really cool. So if I'm, developing an application and I'm connecting to my database and just using T-SQL, I can use CLR to create these custom functions and just expand on my application.
Yeah.
Functionality.
Exactly.
Oh, that's really great. So I imagine there's a lot of people who've used this in the past on, on-prem using SQL Server. Older versions, and you mentioned earlier on that this is in managed instance, so it's not, that's correct, it's not available in Azure SQL Database, the singleton or elastic pools, correct?
Right, correct.
So it's just a managed instance. So we've got some backwards compatibility if we want to move a application that's typically, you know, been on-prem to the cloud, we can use this version of Azure SQL Database Managed Instance.
Yeah, definitely, and that's a great point. If you're migrating to the cloud and want to take advantage of the work you already put into creating these CLR applications, you can still leverage those in Azure.
Well, cool. Well, Anna, thank you very much for showing me how CLR works, and hope you like this little snippet, and just give us a like if you find this information useful, and we'll share a URL with you where you can actually learn more information about CLR. Thank you.
Thanks.